So that's how I met Morgan. I saved his life in the fourth grade, and my sister's been regretting it ever since. Are you okay? You alright?
Before Zachary, Levi would appear in sitcoms including Less Than Perfect and Chuck, as well as the animated musical Tangled by Disney. Disney money.
All those days chasing down a daydream. All those years living in a blur.
Before Zachary was competing in the Celebrity All-Star Game during the 2011 NBA All-Star Weekend.
It's no secret that he has plenty of game for the hardwood. Let's hear it for number 24, Zach Levi.
Before Zachary, Levi dipped into the comic book world with performances in two Thor movies, eventually landing the lead role in 2019's upcoming Shazam film.
This means Billy!
Now, if you guys want to know more about the character Shazam and his fictional origin story, also the creation of the character, well, we've got an entire video on that over on our other channel, Before They're Fiction. Now, this video, of course, it's about Zachary Levi, but before we get into that, there are a few things about Zach that me and him have in common, for real. The main being that I was this dude's stand-in while he was filming here in Toronto on the show Heroes. Secondly, I worked for 3 years as a PA for his one-time wife, Missy Peregrip. And thirdly, and least importantly, well, a girl I once dated stated that my personality was a lot like his cartoon character in Tangled. Okay, I'm stretching it, but you know, I feel like this man's my brother from another mother. What's going on, guys? It's your boy Michael McCredden, documenting the life and career of Zachary Levi prior to fame, here for you on Before They're Famous. Now, I gotta give another plug to our Shazam Before They're Fiction video. There is a link down below. Check that one out as well. And I'll see you guys after the intro. Hey, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell. Boom!
Notice that you've only been showing up at video game events lately.
I mean, I could go to lingerie parties, but I don't look good in Victoria's Secret pink.
Zachary Levi Pugh was born on September 29th, 1980 in Lake Charles, Louisiana, to parents Susan and Darrell. Because he now goes by his middle name of Levi, people often mistake him for being Jewish. And during an interview that took place on the eve of Yom Kippur, well, Zachary once recalled the interviewer asking him if he needed to leave early to prepare for the Jewish holiday. As it turns out, Zachary is not Jewish, but of part Welsh descent. He was told to drop the Welsh surname Pugh, as, well, his agent was like, you know, no one's gonna hire a guy named Zachary Pugh. Although, it worked out for PewDiePie, just gonna say that. Now, Zachary, he grew up a devout Christian. While he has expressed his beliefs in the past, he states he is now more spiritual than he is religious. Nevertheless, he has stated, "My job on my set, I believe, is to first just love people and gain that trust with people, where they know that I really do love them and care about their well-being, so that when they are running into problems, well, they'll hopefully at some point come to me and ask me, what is your peace all about? What is your comfort all about? Where do you get your love? Where do you get your talents?" And I could turn to them and say without blinking, "Jesus Christ." I'm gonna be honest with you guys, Zachary once turned to me and he asked me for a cigarette. You know, after he probably prayed or something. Raised alongside two sisters, Sarah and Shekina, well, he and his family moved around the country for several years, finally settling in Ventura County, California. Now, growing up, Zachary loved video games, starting out in the 80s with Pong and the craze that was Super Mario Bros. Now, Zachary's love of video games would influence some of his future endeavors. He also had a passion for acting, training as a triple threat in acting, dancing, and singing. He acted on stage in productions of The Outsiders, Grease, and The Wizard of Oz. Outside of performing, Zachary stated that his high school experience was god-awful and described getting picked on like no tomorrow. Moving to Hollywood immediately after high school, Zachary began seeking out acting gigs with a performance as Jesus in a musical production of Godspell, which garnered him attention in the business. While he did take part in an unsold TV pilot back in 2001, it wasn't until a year later that he landed his first pro acting role as Adam in a made-for-TV movie called Big Shot, Confessions of a Campus Bookie. And his next role was as Kip Stedman on the ABC sitcom Less Than Perfect.
But I never lost a minute of sleeping. Worried about the way things might have been. Make real, keep on burning.
Zachary enjoyed steady work on the show for 4 seasons, and the show ended in 2006. While Zachary was cast as the lead in the sitcom 3, the show wasn't picked up. Along with several more film and television roles throughout the next half of the 2000s, he landed his biggest television role yet on the comedy spy drama Chuck. Yeah, that's him. The interesting part is that he almost never got the part. Now at the time, he was up for a role in a stage production of Mel Brooks's Young Frankenstein. However, upon scooping up another full-time TV role, he gave up that offer. Deciding to take on Chuck, the actor tapped into his inner nerd, and the actor portrayed ex-CIA agent Chuck Bartowski.
Is that a water gun?
No.
I'm pretty sure it's dripping on my face.
Zachary's performance on the show received critical acclaim, with several online publications listing Chuck as one of the great TV nerds. The program lasted for a good 5 seasons before going off the air in January of 2012. Now, during his tenure on the show, Zachary also had a notable voice role as Flynn Rider in the Disney animated fairy tale Tangled. Love that film. And he starred in this alongside Mandy Moore. Now, Zachary got a chance to exercise his singing muscles, and he took part in the movie's soundtrack. Of course. It's Disney, that's what they do.
All those days, chasing down a daydream. All those years, living in a blur.
Tangled being the most expensive animated film ever made, at least at the time, well, it was both a massive critical and financial success. Such success that Zachary and Mandy, well, they performed their song I See the Light at the Academy Awards in 2011. He went on to lend his voice to the Tangled Ever After short film spinoff, as well as Tangled the Series. It's great, seriously. Now that same year Tangled was released, well, Zachary teamed up with Catherine McPhee for a duet of their song Terrified, and he later appeared in the track's music video. It's a lot of singing. And I'm in love. Around that time, Zachary started up his own company called The Nerd Machine, an online forum for gamers and geeks of all walks of life to come together and share their love for all things nerd. Now Zachary, his intent was to put an end to contemporary nerd stereotypes. And he's a pretty good role model to do that. During San Diego Comic-Con each and every year, he hosts an event called Nerd HQ, where he accepts donations to go to the charity organization Operation Smile. Being nerdy just means being passionate about something, including everyone. The coolest people on Earth are passionate and therefore nerdy about something, whatever it is. Whether it's sports or gaming or technology or fashion or beauty or food or whatever. While Zachary Levi was still not quite a household name, he continued to find work in the acting world. His next big role being that of Fandray in Thor: The Dark World. Now that followed in 2014, and then he tied the knot with Canadian actress Missy Peregrine. And their marriage, however, it didn't last the test of time. And the two split up, about a year after, or less than a year, anyway. Now, despite his marriage troubles, Zachary has approached various aspects of his home life with a hilarious sense of humor. In an interview with Vanity Fair, where he gave a tour of his home, he revealed himself to be overly prepared in the event of an earthquake or even a zombie attack.
My food, rations, and first aid, because, shit's gonna go down.
With brief guest appearances on TV shows such as Heroes Reborn, well, Zachary felt it was time to return to the stage. In 2016, he made his return to the world of Broadway, where he dove into the lead role of George in She Loves Me. Now, critics, they raved about the play, citing Zachary Levi as one of its standouts. In fact, his performance was so praised that he was nominated for a Tony Award in the category of Best Performance by an Actor in a Leading Role.
She loves me. True, she doesn't show it. How could she when she doesn't know it?
In 2017, he briefly reprised his role in 2017's smash hit Thor Ragnarok, and his feet planted in the Marvel series. Well, Zachary then moved over to DC. And in the summer of 2018, a trailer for Shazam, it dropped online.
Oh, hey, what's up? I'm a superhero.
Now, like I told you guys, if you want the rest of the story on Shazam, it's on Before They're Fiction. As for Zachary Levi, well, the rest of the story, you know the story because this is Before They're Famous. Now, Zachary, if you are watching this video, I hope one day to get a call from you to be like your permanent stand-in. That means we can just hang out all the time. I'll be there. We won't smoke anymore because I heard you quit. And I could quit for this bromance to happen. I'm half kidding. See you guys in another video.